Hi, my name is Claus Jørgensen. I'm a microbiologist at DHI. I'm part of a team working with urban water and the health risks associated with human contact to water. Imagine an extreme rain event, a cloud burst, a rain so strong that it occurs only once every 20 years in a city where the drainage systems carry both the rainwater and the human wastewater. The drainage systems will be overwhelmed. A mixture of rainwater and human wastewater will appear on the surface. It will flow in the streets, into the cellars, flood the parks and low-lying areas of the city. At DHI, we are world champions in modeling of urban flooding. Keep in mind that waterborne diseases have been the number one killer throughout history, by far surpassing all other diseases. Especially the children are vulnerable and have suffered. The water utilities have been very successful in protecting the population from waterborne diseases. But we are still vulnerable and at risk of getting infected after contact with wastewater. Imagine again a cloudburst. People will walk around in the flood water and children will even play in the water. Parks are flooded. Later, when the sun is shining again and the water is gone, the parks will be filled with sunbathers, families on picnic, babies playing on the lawn, and many others. Some of them may become ill by touching the contaminated lawn. The climate changes have forced the water utilities to adapt to a higher frequency of extreme rain events. It is very costly. Copenhagen has planned to spend 1,500 million euros in the coming years. It has been estimated that Copenhagen can save 35 million euros if floodwater can temporarily be stored in parks once every 20 to 50 years. But the health authorities are worried about the infection risk. At DHI, we perform experiments to estimate the risk of infection in parks after urban flooding. We have flooded this grass with diluted wastewater and analyzed the grass for pathogenic microorganisms. Based on the results, we can estimate the probability of infection in the weeks following the flood. These results will be used to decide if the parks in Copenhagen can be intentionally flooded. If the risk is too high, we will make recommendations on how to reduce it to an acceptable level. At DHI, we wish to use our hydraulic models and our risk models to make sure that citizens don't get ill after contact with contaminated water. We suggest that climate change adaptations are given a health check before implementation to make sure that solving one problem does not create a new one.